The real difference between male and female brains isn't what you think. Men are better at parking cars. Women are better at multitasking. Men are good at fixing things. Women are good at listening, but they may smash the rearview mirror when listening attentively while backing into a parking space. And who's going to fix that, eh? Don't we love a stereotype? Male and female brains. Same difference? Differences between men and women have not only filled millions of fascinating pub conversations, but also been the focus of countless scientific studies. So what does science have to say about the differences between male and female brains? It's the wrong question. Researchers have been arguing about it for centuries. In 1895, psychologist Gustave Le Bon used a cephalometer to determine that women are an inferior form of human evolution. More recent scientific studies are a little more nuanced. They are still very interested in size. Whoever said it didn't matter? But also in the amount of grey matter, the way our brains are wired, and how different brain areas develop. There are also various studies assessing how men and women score on tasks, such as escaping from a maze. It turns out men are quicker to find the exit, while women are more likely to remember passing a naked statue or a fish pond on the way. How are all these differences linked to each other? There's the rub. While some researchers have singled out slight differences in our brains' looks and shape, no study has been able to establish that these are the actual reasons we are more likely to call our male buddies for help with assembling IKEA furniture. It is, however, well documented that differences in behavior and performance are shaped by society. It is also proven that the brain evolves over time. Neural paths are effectively changed by education and experience. The idea of a male and a female brain is a self-fulfilling prophecy. If we assume that girls have different abilities because they are born that way, it's easy to jump to the conclusion that they shouldn't bother taking up careers in science, for example. So the difference between a male and a female brain is really the packaging, the gender of its owner. Digital technologies can help women to close this gap by improving their access to education. They also reduce inequalities linked to physical differences as low-skilled jobs are increasingly carried out by machines. With AI taking over most repetitive tasks, the demand for more diverse and creative profiles increases. If we make sure all genders have the same opportunities, the result will most certainly be better science.